heartbreaking medical mix-up in 2009 after years of trying for a fourth child. Sean and Carolyn Savage found out they were pregnant. But days later, they learned another woman's embryo had mistakenly been implanted inside of Carolyn. The Savages decided to carry the other couple's baby for them. They shared their story in their new book, Inconceivable, and now they have some very exciting news, and they brought along a very close friend, Jennifer Onash. Good morning to all three of you.
Good morning.
It seems like
you were
just here.
We were.
We're talking about your book, Inconceivable.
Right.
And
yes.
You said, we have our wonderful three children, and that's it. Well, what's the news with Jennifer?
Well, I mean, we are expecting twins. Thanks to Jennifer, just an incredibly generous and a very loving person. We're so lucky to have her in our lives. So
what wonderful news.
Yeah
we're so excited.
And now you're going to have two more babies,
yeah.
Right?
Yes, two more.
You ready for all those diapers?
I think we're ready, yes.
So what made you want to decide to continue trying to have more children after that heartbreaking story of carrying beautiful Logan and giving him to his rightful parents?
You know, I think families have to decide for themselves when their family is complete. And for us, we just felt like we weren't there yet. So we thought we'd go through the process. We were really kind of coming to the end of a road. And but by the grace of God, you know, in our last IVF, it actually worked. So as my doctor said, we kind of hit it out of the ballpark. So.
No kidding, because now you're going to have two. Jennifer, what makes a person like you want to do this for another couple?
Just a desire to help other people, and everybody's story is different. So once you meet, especially Sean and Carolyn, you just know that there's more to do, and I don't know.
It is such a big sacrifice for you, because this is the fourth try. And the first time you got pregnant and had a miscarriage, unfortunately, two more tries after.
Right.
And so how does your family deal with this?
They're fine with it. It is a lot of work, but, you know, I knew we weren't done, so we just had to keep trying. So we knew it would happen.
What does it mean to you, Sean, to know that there's another woman out there who's willing to carry your baby with Carolyn, because Carolyn, for medical reasons, cannot carry any more babies?
It's an incredible blessing. I mean, I don't know what you say other than how thankful we are. I mean, I feel like this journey, that what Jennifer's willing to do for us is beyond comprehension. The fact she's going to sacrifice for our family is incredible. I really feel like God is just holding us in the palm of his hands right now and guiding us to this better place in our lives. And the support, really, of all the Fox viewers ever since our story came out has been incredible. Yeah. Those that have read the book and just, they've been touched. And we didn't give up hope. We never gave up hope. And Jennifer will be with us and our family forever. I mean, she's a guardian angel for us.
So speaking of Logan, that was the beautiful baby that you gave birth to and gave to the Morales. You still have contact with them.
We do. We told them about
You got a big family going on.
Yeah, we told them about the babies earlier this week. In fact, we just told our family and friends prior to coming out here. And they were very excited. They said that this is what they've been praying for all along. So, you know, I think when the end finally comes, I think we're going to have a lot of really neat people who are going to, all of us, including the Morales, feel very blessed.
So the title of your book, Inconceivable, should now be called Conceived.
Or Inconceivable times two.
Exactly.
And by the way, you don't know the sex of the babies yet.
No.
But you do want to find out.
Yeah, and we'll let you know as soon as we do.
Oh, well, thank you so much, Jennifer, Sean, and Carolyn. What a wonderful way to end our week with good news. And for you, the best.
Okay? Thank you, Gretchen.
You.